two things. It will become flame, that is fire and ash.
Then what remains?
Ash and ash.
Fire. You put ghee, what remains? You put a cloth, what remains?
Fire.
Similarly, Sakshi is Jnana Agni.
Okay.
Everything gets converted into Jnanam and burnt. Nothing remains. Sakshi only remains. Brahman only remains.
But again, who witnesses this one?
That is next to next class. 2 months away. Because it's already 2 o'clock. Today's syllabus was, what is thought?
No, beyond consciousness something is there.
You have to understand why this is happening also, no? You have to understand why Maya is there, no?
You told Aham Brahmasmi, I am consciousness, everything.
Aham Brahmasmi have come.
Okay.
Sarvam Khaluvidam Brahma, you have not come.
That also you told, no? So everything, the whole world is consciousness. No?
You are not clear. Sarvam Khaluvidam Brahma, you have not understood. You have not understood why Maya is coming into picture, who is the knower, that question is not answered, you have the question.
Mm.
So these questions will require 4 hours in 2 sessions, each.
Simple, that's the last idea. How objects are itself consciousness, that's what now you explain me, but I couldn't
understand. Okay, let me put it, the modern language you understand.
Mm.
Okay, so this is in the computer, okay. Banking transaction happens.
Okay.
So some $1,000,000 is transferred from one bank to other.
Mm.
Right? So it does it through computer.
Okay.
So what happens in the computer?
Only digital.
Does computer know $1,000,000? Does computer know what is $1,000,000?
No.
Does computer know what is bank A, bank B?
No.
What computer knows?
Computer knows bits and bytes, 1 and 0.
Bits and bytes. And the bits and bytes is only processed in the computer language.
And logic.
For the computer, doesn't bank doesn't exist, money doesn't exist, only bits and bytes.
Yes.
So in consciousness, purely knowledge exists.
But how that knowledge takes the shape of objects?
That is 2 class away.
How you can say, sir?
Sir, it has to go detail step by step. Now I have come to up to this detail step by step. Now if I give a conclusion, I'll say it has never happened.
No, that confusion too much. How that knowing is very much evident, sir.
That's what I'm
saying. How that knowing takes the shape of this different variety of.
That exactly is 2 class away. And there are so many intermediate steps you have to understand.
No, that means there is required something separate from that knowing to bring this happening, correct? No?
Sir, it is suspense.
Knowing itself. How we can generate something?
Thriller ending
can't. There is something different.
I cannot tell you in 2 minutes. I need to take you through step by step to understand how it's happening. Just like I took you step by step to come from outer world to consciousness, I came. Now consciousness to outer world, I have to take you.
Some intelligence is required, no, to bring this all into that.
There is nothing other than consciousness. Then how this happens in the reverse way, I have to explain to you.
So knowing itself. Uses knowing to bring variety. External impulse is required for that. No?
There is no external. Already you have said there is nothing called external.
No, you are telling, but how it can be? Because
your questions are right, answers will have to wait. So far, what I have told, you digest and enter into Nididhyasa. This is sufficient for Nididhyasa. Okay, now still the questions will remain, how the Maya came into picture, how the world came into picture, they're all big questions. Each of them will require $1,000,000 answer. Already it's 2 o'clock. Actually today's syllabus was, one more thing was there, getting into details of thoughts. So next you have to understand what is thoughts. Then you have to understand how thoughts gets created. That's the second class you're asking now, question. To understand what is thought, it takes 4 hours.
Before that, I asked you one thing, do sense organ exists or not? Or without exhaust only everything is known? So that is true, no? There is no sense organ, nothing is there, only the thoughts are there.
There is no thoughts also, there is only Brahman. As per today's discussion, you have come to Sakshi, and Sakshyam are not different. That means only Sakshi remains. Brahman only remains.
No. Brahman, that you told 2 months after that, no sir, that
really. Now today, see, as per you, when Sakshi and Sakshyam have become, or say, one,
then I didn't get sir
that. See, knowledge gets consumed by the knowing.
Knowledge is consumed by the
knowing.
Knowing.
Then where is the knowledge?
But is it true that it is consumed by the knowing?
Yeah.
No, I don't see that knowing is there. In that, all knowledge is there, different knowledges are there. All are, if you feel that all are made up of that knowing, then okay.
Sir, okay, let me start one again. What is this?
Okay, at what level?
No, no. What is this?
Shape.
No, no. Okay. Finally, what is
water
it?
Water bottle.
Water bottle is this? Knowledge came in picture. Okay? Right?
Okay.
Now, what is this? What happened to this knowledge? Consumed.
Yes.
Consumed by whom? Knowing.
Yes, okay.
It is no longer there now.
Okay, correct.
The book knowledge came.
Yes.
It is also consumed.
Yes, it can be consumed. Yes.
Knowing consumes everything like fire. Jnana agni dagda karmani. Okay, nothing remains after that. And please mark my words. Okay, please remember very carefully. Vedanta means end of knowledge. People have thought Vedanta means end of Veda.
Yeah,
Vedanta means end of knowledge. Every knowledge ends in consumption. Who by whom? Sakshi. Then knowledge is gone.
But instead of consumption, it is changing.
No,
not consumption means it is gone. No, no, no more.
Sir, the knowledge of the book is gone, sir.
No, because instead of that, something else has gone.
That is gone.
So it has changed.
It is gone now. This knowledge. Okay, see, only one thing can happen at a time. This is a book. The knowledge is there.
Okay.
Okay, Sakshi says, I know.
Yeah.
Right? Over.
No, this has come.
That's what I mean. Knowledge keeps changing, but it ends up in consumption by the knowing. Who is the consumer? Final consumer is knowing. Right? Once this knowing is over, the job is over.
As I said, for, no, TV screen is there, in that something is, bottle is there. If you just click, some other cup is coming. So that means the screen image has changed. Can you say that it is consumed by the TV?
No. TV is an object here.
You don't take consumed in literal.
This is not a consumed. TV is an object.
It's not destroyed.
No. It's
see, TV is an object.
Okay.
Right?
I think his confusion is consumed means it's eaten up.
No.
Destroyed.
No.
It just changed into.
There is nothing called knowledge after that.
Okay.
See, it has reached the end user, which is knowing. Then after.
Again, this bottle if comes.
Again, another fresh knowledge.
Fresh
instance. Every instance is a fresh instance.
Yes.
So for whom? For the Sakshi. Everything is done for the Atma. For the Atma. Once it reaches the Atma, it becomes knowing. Over. Finished. This is the real meaning of Vedanta. People think Vedanta has a lot of, 100 books, you tell me one meaning of this, given this nature. Everything gets consumed in the fire of Sakshi, Jnana, knowing. Gone. Nothing is there. Then comes, was there an object? Was there a body? Was there a thought? We will analyze in the next 2 classes.
No, but from that knowing also, again some object is coming
up. Now we have to come the reverse way, sir. So the reverse way, we'll take 2 classes, I said.
So what is consumed in that? From there itself, this bottle has come out.
No,
nothing can come out after you put fire, water, ghee into the fire. Get back ghee.
No, in this analogy, it may be not true, but here...
Analogy is true. That's why they did yatna. It's an exact analogy.
No sir, now I am seeing this photo. Now how this photo has come? It is from the constitutional knowledge.
Photo has not come. How it has not come, we will find out.
If it has not come, then it can be consumed also.
In the ultimate sense, nothing has come out.
Oh, ultimate sense, you know?
So now in the intermediate sense, we have to understand Maya, the process of Maya. That requires 2 classes. For understanding the process of Maya, first you have to understand thought. Then how thought gets converted into Maya is next class. Okay, how to come out of this mess is another class. So was this class useful? ಏನ್ರಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆಯಾ? ಧ್ಯಾನನೇ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ ಅಪ್ಪ ನೀವು. ಏನ್ರಿ ದ್ವೈತ ಎಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಪ್ಪ ನಮ್ಗೆ. ನನ್ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ದಿವಸ ಭಗವಂತ ಸೇರ್ಬೇಕು, ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡಿ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡಿ. ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು? ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಡಿಫೆನ್ ತೋರಿಸಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾರು ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ. ಆ ಚೈತನ್ಯನೇ ಭಗವಂತ. ಆ ಭಗವಂತ ಏನು ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡೋದು? ಯಾರು ಸಾಧನೆ ಮಾಡೋದು? ಯಾರು ಅರ್ಥಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು? ಈ ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟವಾದ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಹೊಡಿತಾರೆ, ಬೇಕಾದ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಹೊಡಿತಾರೆ. ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಉಷಾ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಬೇಕೇನ್ರಿ? ಒಂದು ಕೋಟಿ ರಾಮನಾಮ ಜಪ ಮಾಡಿ.